क्या ही होता है माता जी?
ओके, वेलकम टू भक्ति संघ जप कॉन्फ्रेंस। सो टुडेज क्लास विल बी गिवन बाय हिज ग्रेस रामगिरिधारी प्रभु जी ऑन द टॉपिक ऑफ श्री चैतन्य चरितामृत चैप्टर 8 टेक्स्ट नंबर 9 अंत्यलीला श्री चैतन्य चरितामृत Chapter 8 and text number 9 forward. Adi. Ram Giridhari Prabhu, are you there?
Hare Krishna. Yes, Dandavat. I'm sorry, I will not be able to turn on my video because I have my data connected. So please excuse me.
That's okay, Prabhuji. Thank you very much, Prabhuji. Please accept my humble obeisances. All good to Srila Prabhupada. And thank you very much for giving your very valuable time and association to us this morning and enlightening us on this topic. Please take over the call now, Prabhuji. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। जय जय श्री चैतन्य जय नित्यानंद जय द्वैत चंद्र जय गौर भक्त वृंद। जय जय श्री चैतन्य जय नित्यानंद जय द्वैत चंद्र जय गौर भक्त वृंद। सो वी आर रीडिंग फ्रॉम श्री चैतन्य चरितामृता अंत्यलीला चैप्टर 8 टेक्स्ट नंबर 9 ऑनवर्ड्स एंड वी आर गोइंग टू रीड टिल टेक्स्ट नंबर 21। सो वी विल रीड द श्लोक ट्रांसलेशन एंड इफ देयर इज परपोर्ट एंड देन वी विल कंसोलिडेट आवर डिस्कशंस। टेक्स्ट नंबर 9। महाप्रभु कैल तांद्रे दंडवत नति आलिंगन करी तेनो कैला कृष्ण स्मृति। श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभु ऑल्सो ऑफर्ड ओबेसेंसेस अंटू रामचंद्रपुरी हू देन एम्ब्रेस्ड हिम एंड दस रिमेंबर्ड कृष्ण। परपोर्ट, श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभु ऑफर्ड ओबेसेंसेस टू रामचंद्रपुरी इन कंसिडरेशन ऑफ his being a disciple of Srila Madhavendra Puri, the spiritual master of his own spiritual master, Ishwara Puri. When a Vaishnava sannyasi meets another Vaishnava sannyasi, they both remember Krishna. Even Mayavadi sannyasis generally remember Narayana, who is also Krishna, by saying Om Namo Bhagavate Narayanaya or Namo Narayanaya. Thus, it is the duty of a sannyasi to remember Krishna. According to Smriti Sastra, a sannyasi does not offer obeisances or blessings to anyone. It is said, sannyasi nirashir nirna mashkriya. A sannyasi should not offer anyone blessings or obeisances. Text 10. तीन जने इष्ट गोष्ठी कैल कथ क्षण जगदानंद पंडित तांद्रे कैला निमंत्रण। The three of them talked about Krishna for some time and then Jagadananda came and extended an invitation to Ramachandrapuri. Text 11. जगन्नाथेर प्रसाद आनील भिक्षा लागिया यथेष्टा भिक्षा करीला तेनो निंदार लागिया। A large quantity of remnants of food from Lord Jagannath was brought in for distribution. Ramachandrapuri ate sumptuously and then he wanted to find faults in Jagadananda Pandita. Text 12. भिक्षकरी कहे पुरी सुन जगदानंदा अवशेषा प्रसाद तुमी करहा भक्षणा। After finishing the meal, Ramachandrapuri requested, my dear Jagadananda, please listen. You eat the food that is left. Text 13. Agraha kariya tandre vashi kao yailam. Apane agraha kari pariveshana kailam. With great eagerness, Ramachandra Puri seated Pandita, Jagadananda Pandita, and personally served him prasadam. Text 14. Agraha kariya punah punah kao ilam. Achamana kaila ninda karita lagilam. Encouraging him again and again, Ramachandra Puri fed him sumptuously. But while Jagadananda had washed his hands and mouth, Ramachandra Puri began criticizing him. Suni Chaitanya Ganakare Bahuta Bhakshana Satya Sei Vakya Sakshat Dekilum Ekanam. I have heard, he said, that the followers of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu eat more than necessary. Now I have directly seen that this is true. Text 16. Sanyashire etakao yanakare dharma nasham. Vairagi hana etakaya vairagera nahi bhasham. Feeding a sannyasi too much breaks his regulative principle. For when a sannyasi eats too much, his renunciation is destroyed. Text 17. Yeita swabhavatandra agraha kariyam piche ninda kare agi bahuta kaoyanam. The characteristics of Ramachandra Puri was that first he would induce someone to eat more than necessary and then he would criticize him. Text 18. Purveyabe Madhavendra Karena Antara Dhanam Ramachandra Puri Tabe Aila Tandrastanam. Formerly, when Madhavendra Puri was at the last stage of his life, Ramachandra Puri came to where he was staying. Puri Goshai Kare Krishna Nama Sankirtanam Matura na painu bali karena krandanam. Madhavendra Puri was chanting the holy name of Krishna and sometimes he would cry, "Oh my Lord, I did not get shelter at Mathura." Text 20. Ramachandra Puri tabe upadeshe tandre sishyahana guru ke kahe bhaya nahi kare. Then Ramachandra Puri was so foolish that he fearlessly dared to instruct his spiritual master. Text 21. Tumi purna brahmananda karaha smarana brahma vidhana kene karaha rodhana. If you are in full transcendental bliss, he said, you should now remember only Brahman. Why are you crying? Purport. As stated in Bhagavad Gita, Brahma Bhuta Prasanna Atma, a Brahman realized person is always happy. Na sochati na kankshati. He neither laments nor aspires for anything. Not knowing why Madhavendra Puri was crying, Ramachandra Puri tried to become his advisor. Thus, he committed a great offense. For a disciple should never try to instruct his spiritual master. Om Ajnana Timirandasya Jnananjana Shalakayam Chakshurun Militam Yenam Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Nama Om Vishnu Padayam Krishna Preshtaya Bhutale Srimate Bhaktivedanta Swamin Iti Namine Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Sunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya
प्रभु नित्यानंदाम श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासदी गौर भक्त वृंदाम हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा वेलकम यू ऑल टू दिस मिड मॉर्निंग चैतन्य चरितामृत सेशन इट्स अ प्लेजर टू बी विद यू ऑल एंड इट्स आल्सो अ प्रिविलेज टू डिस्कस अबाउट दिस वंडरफुल ग्लोरीज ऑफ श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभु एंड हिज टीचिंग्स एंड लाइफ दिस पर्टिकुलर सेक्शन ऑफ श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभुस लीला especially the dealings of Mahaprabhu with Ramachandra Puri is highly important for us to understand, realize them, apply them, and preach them. It may be bewildering that we state this statement of highly important in many, many times whilst we are reading Srimad Bhagavatam. But then, because Srimad Bhagavatam and the science of Krishna consciousness is a absolute phenomena, it is not a relative one. So, this absolute statement is always absolute. Purnamada purnamidam purnad purnamudasyate purnasya purnamataya purnameva vasishyate. Which means every statement, when we say it's important, it is important, mutually exclusively important. And even if any one instruction is strictly and nicely followed, all the other instructions would automatically get revealed and manifested. So that is the beauty of such science. But it is imperative that we highlight the importance every time so that the doggish mentality within us gets reminded, re-reminded, re-re-reminded for us to practice the science of Krishna consciousness. The context here is that Ramachandra Puri is the god brother of Ishwara Puri, who is the spiritual master of Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And that way, Ramachandra Puri happens to be, in terms of the current arrangement, he is senior to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to an extent. Mahaprabhu looked at him as he used to look at his spiritual master. In terms of Ramachandra Puri's characteristics, we are reading over here about his propensity to induce, find fault, demean, humiliate others, and that has become his second nature. And in the course of his visiting Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he couldn't control that propensity. And this current context is where he is exhibiting that irritation, that funny characteristics of him towards Jagadananda Pandita. To put it simple, Ramachandra Puri, for various practical and impractical reasons, has become a willful defaulter. He maybe knowingly, but uncontrollably became an antagonist, or to put in a way, he has become a fault finder, criticizer. And in every walks of his life, he started to criticize his near and dear ones. Through this particular section, there are several lessons that we can learn, but we will try to limit within our limited time whatever best possible that we could learn, and at least try to apply, try to understand, assimilate, apply, and preach. To begin with, I would like to make a definition that Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu or Vrindavan Das Thakur is making in Chaitanya Bhagavata on this criticism. He says, Vrindavan Das Thakura says, Anindaka hoy je, Sakrit Krishna Bhaje Satya Satya Muyitare Udarilo Hele. He says, he was referring to what Mahaprabhu used to say. Mahaprabhu has got only two requests to all of us. Anindaka hoy je. Ninda means criticism, fault finding. And Sakrit Krishna Bhaje, with that frame of mind, constantly chant the holy name of the Lord. Satya Satya Muhitare Udarilo Hele. Krishna, as Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, is making a promise, not once, but twice. I promise, I will deliver that person. So what are his two expectations? Number one is no criticism. And number two is to chant the holy name of the Lord. The most interesting aspect here is that he didn't classify as we would have expected. Oh, please allow us to at least criticize materialistic men. Oh, please allow us to criticize my non-cooperative mother-in-law. Please allow me to criticize my non-supportive daughter-in-law. Please allow me to criticize envious person. He didn't give any classification. Because criticism is not about what others are up to. Criticism is about what is within us and what propensity we behold. So, my introduction point of this particular discussion is going to be that criticism is a scenario, is a mentality, it's a propensity, independent of what the other person's nature is. It is a dirt, disease, virus within one, and that needs to be curbed. No excuse whatsoever may be can justify criticism. That is what is established from this particular episode. You will see the later part of it in the subsequent section, subsequent classes. But here, we see the propensity of criticism within Ramachandra Puri induced him to do such an act where he forcefully fed Jagadananda Pandit as if he is showing his love. And because of Ramachandra Puri's whatever position that he had as god brother of Ishwara Puri and disciple of Madhavendra Puri, if Mahaprabhu is giving respect, what do you think of Jagadananda Pandit? He will disrespect. He had to respect, obey, and out of humility accepted all those that was fed to him, and that too is Jagannath Prasad. Ramachandra Puri went on to criticize because of his own inducement. He tried to use it against them. This is the nature of criticism, where you would want to go on. You are not able to control your urge to find fault. Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Maharaj used to tell a very wonderful, story. You can get to read them in his book, Upakhyani Upadesh. Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Maharaj used to say, there were two friends. And one person was always envious of the other. And the envious one happened to meet a common friend of him. And they had this exchange. Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Maharaj says, so, hey, do you know that so-and-so friend of us, he never used to study very nicely. But the second person said, but my dear friend, he has now graduated nicely and became a magistrate. But the first one said, probably he would have joined the job for no salary or less salary. So, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Maharaj is writing, because of the envious nature, because of the propensity to find fault, the person will not be able to accept, appreciate, recognize, endorse the other person's achievement or success. So, my first reflection is, Mahaprabhu's request needs to be completely abided. And even if nothing else is done, this instruction will be good enough to take us back home, back to Godhead. If somehow or other we are able to control the urge to find fault, to criticize, and somehow or other, if we are able to practice the chanting of the holy name of the Lord, then we are pretty safe. This is my first reflection. And as a part of the sub-points of this reflection, I would like to make a note saying that criticism has nothing to do with other person's behavior. It is very much to do with our propensity, our urge. And hence, nobody can be blamed. We can't hold anyone responsible. The second reflection is, I would like to state, what are all those qualities which are all associated with criticism, and that needs to be very carefully avoided or handled. Or they may be similar, or they may be in line with criticism. One can be replaced with other in different context. So, one needs to understand that this is just not a superficial moral value. This is about the crux of protecting our Krishna consciousness, Bhakti Lata Beej. So criticism is like pouring acid onto a very fertile seed which can eventually reap us lots of fruits. So hence, don't handle this aspect of criticism as some spiritual morality or some important value. It is just not that much. To an extent, to say, by just one of this quality, our Krishna consciousness shall be defined. The way I handle others' criticism upon me, the way I handle others' faults that I happen to see, tells who am I in my Krishna consciousness. Ego, envy, judgmental, and pride are the four associated qualities of this criticism, oblique fault-finding nature. Prakriti kriyamanani gunai karmani sarvasaha ahankara vimudatma kartaham iti manyate. Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, kartaham iti manyate is a vimuda. The person who thinks that I am the doer, I am the benefactor, I am the enjoyer, is actually vimuda, not just muda, it is super muda. So hence, these qualities like ego, envy, pride, and judgmental nature has got no absolute value and presence in Krishna consciousness dimension. Hence, my second reflection is about how do we learn to relinquish these qualities and understand that criticism has got no place in Krishna consciousness, and it is actually the core of our Krishna consciousness. Third reflection, many a times we kind of ask for rationalization and also some leeway that in certain circumstances, certain things can be allowed. Is there anything for such an act of criticism? Because we get to hear Prabhuji as a preacher, I may need to be judging others. As a counselor, I may need to be evaluating somebody else's good and bad qualities. So how does we do that service? The answer is that one is the nature of the service towards correcting someone does not require criticism. It only requires to analyze and give feedback. Sometimes we use this word in the corporate world called as constructive criticism. It is nothing but a diplomatic statement that I will find fault, but don't take me otherwise. The word feedback versus criticism can be very easily differentiated. Feedback means I will be able to list both the positive ones as well as the room for improvement ones. Criticism means we will only address about those which are faults. So, communicating something that is not okay has got some character. If I have to identify 4 mistakes or 4 things to be corrected, if I were a matured practitioner, the way I should go about in doing that is to identify 15 or substantial good qualities, appreciable qualities, before we identify some rooms for improvement. This communicates a very clear-cut message saying that the intent is not to snub you off or humiliate or irritate. The intent is to purely make some contribution for improving on the results. So the third aspect that I want to say is about differentiating between feedback and criticism. And the word constructive criticism is a dangerous one, because we will start with a name called constructive criticism and that eventually become only criticism, and the constructivity will get lost. So that is why, in general, if at all we are engaged in some service which involves to identify mistakes and try to correct the students under you, we are supposed to use what is called as feedback. This is always mode of goodness. Also, this is the way by which we can correct someone. If only faults and mistakes are identified and presented, and good things are never identified and appreciated, then even though your original intention may have been to help, the nature of criticism will pollute the consciousness of the person who criticizes. The fourth reflection is about few examples. And we will see this example from a different cross section. I'm going to give 5 different episodes in which how this criticism have been handled. Then, as a part of the last reflection, we will talk about Mahaprabhu's and Madhavendra Puri's dealings to Ramachandra Puri on this criticism. Number one is about Daksha versus Lord Shiva. Daksha was very envious towards Lord Shiva. Daksha did not like Lord Shiva. Even though Shivaji was Daksha's son-in-law, Daksha did not like, for various practical reasons, according to Daksha, whilst he was absolutely wrong. Daksha went on to an extent to humiliate, insult, criticize, abuse, accuse, ill-treat Lord Shiva, not just privately, but publicly. 4th canto, 2nd chapter, completely talks about Daksha's accusations against Lord Shiva. And finally, he is bringing in a justification how he didn't mean to target Lord Shiva, but his intent was to rescue and help the masses. Srila Prabhupada writes that he is such a degraded mindset and such a stupid argument or logic for his criticism. And this criticizing of Daksha towards Lord Shiva went on to an extent that in his next performance of fire sacrifice, he did not call Lord Shiva, even though all the demigods were invited. To cut the long story short, finally Lord Shiva happened to visit Daksha because of the forceful act of Parvati, Sati. So Lord Shiva had to go there. And because Daksha, out of his arrogance, he kept on humiliating, insulting Lord Shiva. And that hurt several disciples of Lord Shiva, including his own wife, Sati, who happened to kill herself by committing suicide. So to teach the lesson to the entire mass, even though Lord Shiva was not personally affected, Lord Shiva had to chop off Daksha's head. So the storyline is, because of enviousness, Daksha did not give one single word of appreciation to Lord Shiva, criticized Lord Shiva, and finally he was punished by Lord Shiva by getting his head chopped off. And eventually he had to ask for forgiveness because of the intervening of Brahma. He was given goat's head and he had to compose a prayer called Chamakam, which is very interesting to chant, to, you know, you will see that as a part of that prayer, you will know how a goat used to produce some specific sound. The prayer will also have, as a part of the meter, that sound is produced. Prayaschame, prayaschame. So every second line, you will use this, you will get the sound meh, meh, like the goat, because Daksha used to be so proud about his beauty, knowledge, position, power, and used to be head weighted, and Lord Shiva gave a befitting punishment. So this is first. Second, Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj was a very humble, simple, and a very strict practitioner. And he had a wonderful practice of Gaudiya Vaishnava Siddhanta. Out of his humility, several times he has expressed some very humble statements to an extent. He said that, "I am not a qualified devotee. I need to smear the dirt of all the Gaudiya Vaishnavas upon my body. So when I leave this body, please drag my body in the streets of Mayapur Dham." This is a height of humility which was not understood by several so-called bogus sadhus. When Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj actually left this planet, all these sadhus, they came to claim the body of Babaji Maharaj. Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Maharaj, who happened to be his disciple, knew who these Babajis were. Not all of them, or not most of them, were in good standing in their own personal lives. They were all the so-called caste Goswamis or caste Babas, showing off their spiritual identity to loot wealth and have sense gratification. So when they started to claim Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj's body, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Maharaj made a public announcement, because he knew that these were the people who used to criticize about Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj, because Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj used to have a very simple, humble lifestyle. He used to wear very humble clothing, very humble attire. So they used to make fun of him. And as a part of that, they had enviousness and they used to criticize. But then, just to take some credit, they were trying to claim his body. Even some of them had an audacity to state that it was the last wish of Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj that his body be dragged in the streets of Mayapur Dham. So I would like to fulfill that desire. So Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Maharaj was so upset and so particular, and he made a public statement that anyone who had not had illicit sex in the last 1 hour can touch the body of my Gurudev. So there were several people who never came forward because they knew that Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Maharaj's stature and his authority. When nobody came forward, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Maharaj said, even if somebody has not done illicit sex in the last 1 day, you can come forward and claim his body. Nobody came forward. Then he said, 1 week, 2 weeks. So he kept on saying that so long as you are having sense gratificatory propensity and committing illicit sex in the name of sadhu, in the garb of a sadhu, what rights you have to come and claim such a wonderful personality as Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj? And when nobody had the courage, because if they had come forward, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Maharaj would have exposed them. The reason I am trying to bring this story into this current context is that those criticisms, those claims, those behaviors that they had when Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj was alive, and their enviousness and ego within themselves, were never tolerated by Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur. So he immediately chastised them and shooed them away and did his own self, the Samadhi ceremony of Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj. Third, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Maharaj, before even Srila Prabhupada used to go to overseas to preach Krishna consciousness, in Gaudiya Math, they had arranged for one of the disciples of Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Maharaj to go to London. So they had spent significant amount of money to take care and fund the preaching initiative of this disciple of Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, so that what Mahaprabhu actually desired, that all over the world people will chant and dance to the holy name of the Lord, can be fulfilled. But after staying overseas for several months, this disciple came back to Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Maharaj and told Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Maharaj that, my dear Gurudev, there is something wrong in our Siddhanta or in our presentation. We need to adjust our presentation to suit the Western audience so that they will also be able to take up Krishna consciousness. So can you look at your commentaries and instructions and teachings so that we can tweak them to adopt to the Western audience? The similar mindset of Ramachandra Puri was exhibited there. Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Maharaj was so upset, so much so, that he said, I disown you as my disciple, and you are not even eligible to come to my samadhi ceremony. It is very rare to get a bona fide spiritual master in one's life. And if somebody offend a bona fide spiritual master, it will be very rare to get a spiritual master again in his entire life. So the third example here about the effect of criticism or finding fault at one's spiritual authority is that he got a curse, anguish of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Maharaj, so much so that he was disowned by Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Maharaj. Fourth example is about Srila Prabhupada writing in the context of Uddhava, Vidura and Maitreya Rishi. He is explaining about the concept of Maryada Vyatikrama. He explains that if anyone does not follow the principle of Maryada Vyatikrama, their ability to progress in Krishna consciousness will be completely finished and doomed. It is said that in comparison to Uddhava, Maitreya was senior. So it was decided, of course, there is an internal reasons also, because Krishna wanted Uddhava to go to accomplish some other tasks. But Prabhupada writes there that one practitioner should make sure that he does not override, he does not disrespect his superiors and seniors, and should always follow an etiquette. Otherwise, his spiritual life will be finished. Over here, it is not even criticism. It is about talking over one's spiritual authority is itself considered as detrimental to spiritual life. What to speak of criticizing? Episode number 5. This is about Bhakti Vinod Thakur, who, when he was preaching about Bhagavatam to various groups and establishing the supremacy of Srimad Bhagavatam, he also was on the hunt of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's Janmasthan. He traveled several places only in Bengal and found out 13 different apasampradayis. He had actually documented them. Srila Prabhupada has actually mentioned them in Chaitanya Charitamrita. And His Holiness Suhotra Swami, one of the disciples of Srila Prabhupada, has compiled a book on Apasampradaya, in which he has spoken about all these 13 Apasampradayis. We had the good fortune of discussing about this entire 13 classifications during our lockdown lecture series that I was giving to my Mumbai congregation devotees. The point I'm trying to bring it here is, when Bhakti Vinod Thakur traveled around all these places and found, and he said, only in Bengal, only in Gaudadesh, we have 13. What to speak of other places? And the basic definition that he gave, or basic aspect of Apasampradaya, is one who is envious of the process of Krishna consciousness, and one who has an intention to enjoy sense gratificatory propensity. Name, fame, power, position, followers, illicit sex, money, and they use Krishna
and the process of Krishna consciousness in their favor. So these five examples are to establish how criticism is never tolerated, and anyone who criticizes will be punished severely. In Madhavendra Puri's context, when Ramachandra Puri used to criticize the 21st verse that we read today, where he has mentioned to his own spiritual master, who out of his own humility, out of his own separation from the Supreme Lord, he was expressing his separation from the Supreme Lord. And Ramachandra Puri did not understand what his spiritual master's stature was, his position was, his consciousness was. And he kind of, you know, gave some additional jnana, and which happened to be his, you know, misfortune. Or, and the problem is, it was not just because of this one episode. If you happen to know the life of Ramachandra Puri and Ishwara Puri, the biggest comparison that Srila Prabhupada says, the reason Ramachandra Puri is not able to appreciate, not able to serve, not able to glorify Madhavendra Puri was that he never served his guru. Whilst Ishwara Puri did every part of menial service to Madhavendra Puri, from cleaning him, bathing him, taking him to the toilet, washing him, and every menial service he did. And when Ishwara Puri used to serve Madhavendra Puri, Ramachandra Puri used to mock at Ishwara Puri and make fun of him. So the underlying fact is, a person criticizes, a person develops the sense of fault finding when he is not serving Vaishnavas and spiritual masters. And this serving a spiritual master, one gets Krishna as a disciple, that is Ishwara Puri. And not serving a spiritual master, one gets rejected by Krishna. That is what this story of Ramachandra Puri that you are going to see. So that leads us to the fourth reflection, wherein, what are we supposed to be doing? How are we supposed to conduct ourselves? And we will see what Mahaprabhu did. You will discuss them in detail, but I'll at least, you know, conclude by this logical end of this discussion, where when we are put into service, when we are practicing Krishna consciousness, because of not having proper samskaras, because of not have a proper upbringing, only because of the mercy of some Vaishnavas, we somehow got Krishna consciousness, not at an early age, but at whatever later age. We may be struggling with this quality of finding fault at others. So hence, we all should be very carefully working towards the following sets of points, so that we can try to help ourselves and in turn serve others. So if somebody wants to work on themselves to not to find faults, the following are few reflections, suggestions, recommendations that I would like to share. Number one, that learn to have a sense of appreciation, genuine appreciation to all the devotees that we know. So be an appreciative personality. In the sense, learn to fine-tune the way we interact with this world, not necessarily only Vaishnavas, but we can learn to appreciate all that is good around us. Because after all, everything belongs to Krishna and we are also Krishna's. So if they are all Krishna's, so why don't we appreciate them in connection with Krishna? Maybe somebody is misusing them. Maybe somebody is doing something else. So Satsarup Maharaj mentions this in the Obstacles on the Path of Krishna Consciousness book. Appreciation is a very good quality by which we can overcome certain fault finding and envious nature. I'm not able to exactly remember the phrase. But the point is, appreciation is a very important aspect that we need to inculcate. Generally appreciate. Number two, if at all you are a parent, you are a counselor, you are a senior, you are a teacher, you happen to instruct or correct your subordinate, please try to give feedback rather than criticism. And I already mentioned what a feedback is. Feedback means we give both good things as well as room for improvement. And the proportion is, for every room for improvement, we give five good things. Or every for five good things, one room for improvement. If somebody says that I am not able to see any good thing in a person, then it is not a problem of that person. It is a problem of the individual. We always used to say in our corporate world, if an auditor has not found a fault or a mistake, he is already a corrupt officer. Because there is no one in this world who is an ideal perfect in the materialistic context. I mean, that's the rational. If you are doing an audit, you should have a finding. If you don't have a finding, you have not done proper audit or you are corrupt. Similarly, I mean, this is in a, you know, reverse sense. So if at all we are trying to appreciate someone, I mean, if at all we are trying to correct someone, try to find out some good things in him so that the message is communicated clearly and at the same time your intent and your consciousness is also, you know, properly managed. Third, in our devotional service, if we happen to see something not appropriate towards our seniors, all we can do, this is how I manage, maybe there are other strategies that you all have, all I see is that, my dear Lord, please don't reveal such things to me where I'm not able to understand. And I also try to pray to Krishna if at all there are some aspects that you want to get noticed, you please take care of this. You are a better judge. So basically all I want to say is that the correcting the seniors is not our agenda. And that somebody else will take care. Unless and otherwise, there is a safety issue and there is a scenario of society's preaching is hampered because of that so-called personal question. The next thing that I always recommend for those who are going through this challenge of criticism, Rasaraj Prabhu, one of the senior devotees in Radha Rasbihar temple, he's been there in the movement for a long time. He once mentioned, learn to be pessimistic on yourself and optimistic on others. Try to find how you have not done certain things correctly and how others have done certain things correctly. Because at the end, it is a Krishna consciousness dealing between you, Guru, Krishna, and Dham. All the others are only support system. Now, this list can go on and on and on, but this at least gives an indication that we need to handle ourselves very well to avoid ourselves from criticizing others. And just want to make a last point in this list is, if somebody criticizes you, accept them as an opportunity to develop humility and tolerance. Just only thing, make sure that you are not exploited in the name of criticism. If somebody criticizes anyone else in front of you, and that person is, the person being criticized is a devotee, please do not tolerate, please retaliate or respond back. So, criticizing ourselves, we need to learn to tolerate, just to make sure that we are not just exploited, that's all. Otherwise, let them criticize and move on. We can list stories after stories onto this. Rupa Goswami happened to meet Digvijay Pandit, and Rupa Goswami was challenged by Digvijay Pandit. And Rupa Goswami did not want to spend any time to challenge Krishna consciousness aspect. He said, I agree that I got defeated by you. Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Maharaj went for a installation and Kumbhabhisheka, the coronation ceremony, temple installation ceremony, temple inauguration ceremony. He asked for a particular brahmachari where he was missing. Everybody were listing several mistakes of this brahmachari and told that we threw him out of the temple. Then Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Maharaj asked, you all have categorically listed all the mistakes that he has done. Are you saying that he does not have any one single good quality that you all could list? Everybody said that he is a very good kirtan singer. Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Maharaj asked, then why you are not listed there? Unless he is coming back, I am not going to perform this installation ceremony. So they all went and found him in one watch repair shop where he was sitting and crying and repenting about his mistakes. And when he heard that Gurudev had compassion for you, he accepted that, yes, I had this fault. But then I also did not want to leave you all, leave this wonderful association. So thank you so much. I will try to work on myself. Please help me in this process. That is the spirit of a Vaishnava association. Now to conclude, how did Mahaprabhu handle Ramachandrapuri? Very nice. You look at when Ramachandrapuri came, he offered respects. So he didn't disrespect. Then when Ramachandrapuri started to find fault at Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, about which you are going to read it later, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu did not say anything. But he also stopped or reduced eating. So much so that he kind of respected. At the same time, he kind of rejected Ramachandrapuri's propensity. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he has chastised Chota Haridas. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he slapped the servant who came with Mahaprabhu to Vrindavan to serve him and went and told that Krishna has appeared in Yamuna and is dancing on Kaliya hood. So he slapped him. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was upset on Jagadananda Pandit when he told Sanatana Goswami to go to Vrindavan. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu did not retaliate, did not shout or do anything with
Ramachandrapuri, but you handled in a very gentle, humble manner. So even if it happens to be your senior doing something that is not so good, it's as much as possible better to avoid and leave that Sangha and seek a better Sangha rather than, you know, trying to criticize. And this particular episode, when you all complete, I guess each and every one of us, if we take the sankalpa of Anindaka Hoije, Sakrit Krishna Bhaje, Satya Satya Muhitare, Uddari Lo Hele. Prabhuji's and Mataji's, this particular aspect of criticism is not just only about us and devotees. It is also about us with everyone in this world. It is about the dirt. It is not about dirt within us, not about dirt outside. So let's all work, help, endure, and try to inspire each other to lead a life which is free from criticism. Shri Shri Chaitanya Charitamrita ki jai, Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Itai Gaurav Premanande Hari Hari Bol. If there are any questions or comments, we can discuss.
Thank you, Prabhuji. Very nicely you have explained about how we should try to avoid the offenses. Thank you very much, Prabhuji. If anybody has any question, please go ahead.
Okay, I see a question in the chat. How should we approach while criticizing our own while doing self-introspection? Does it become self-envy if we criticize our own more than required? Well, I was not saying that we should criticize ourselves. I was just trying to say is that we should identify the rooms for improvement within ourselves. I mean, we should be pessimistic to ourselves. Doesn't mean we should be criticizing to ourselves. When the word pessimism means that I am not trying to be identifying, only of my good things, how great I am, how perfect I am. It was about how I more focus on. I mean, the intent is that not to dwell on our success, rather to dwell on what we need to improve upon. That doesn't mean that we should criticize ourselves. We should envy ourselves. This is definitely, we should be self-compassionate. And one of the way of being self-compassionate is not to, you know, over-harm, not to harm us, rather than we should educate us to take shelter of some self-realized soul. It is his duty to help us to come out of all these vices. On our own, we will not be able to manage. So when we do self-introspection, the only identification that we need to do is that how am I supposed to do amanina manadena and how am I supposed to do trinatapi sunichena? How am I supposed to do amanina manadena on others and trinatapi sunichena on myself? And for this, I will take help from all my near and dear ones. Dattatre story or the Bhagavatam is talking about how we can learn from everyone, even from the nature. 24 different spiritual masters are listed. There's a book by Hridayananda Maharaj called Enlightenment by the Natural Path. Very nicely has explained the aspects from the 11th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. The point is, it is important for us to practice in such a manner that we are in the forward march, not that we are in a... I mean, our spiritual life is not to whip on our back. Spiritual life is to pat on our back. And Krishna is such a person who gives credit even for the slightest and smallest seva that we have done. And he forgives sometimes the most gravest and gravest mistakes. So, making sense? Okay. What if you have to warn someone against some bad quality of some other person? Definitely. Sometimes you may have to educate. Sometimes we may have to
point out as a matter of a friendly, as a recommendation, suggestion, and teaching. So generally, this pungent responses or any pungent statements or any punitive statements can give rise to punitive responses also. It is like this. If you have to teach a child, so my father had been a teacher, a very good teacher. I've learned a lot from him. So he used to always tell me that how you relate and deal with a child, in correcting the child will be able to consider you as a teacher or consider you as a obstacle in his desire to do sense gratification. So the point he was trying to say was, even when you want to correct a child, correct a person who is naughty, correct a person who is not following certain things, if you can communicate in a manner, 17.15 Bhagavad Gita, Anudvega Karam Vakyam Satyam Priyahitam Chayat. Five things Krishna says: truthful, beneficial, pleasing, not agitating others, always speak from Vedic literature. And interesting thing is, all these five are not either or, all these five are and. Truthful, and beneficial, and pleasing, and not agitating others, and speaking from Vedic literature. Very tough, but it is not impossible. On a lighter note, there are some transcendental jokes. There are some transcendental, allegations. Very nicely, very jokingly, certain things are communicated and conveyed also. The bottom line is that if you have to warn someone, you can also try to approach a methodology of appreciating, give a feedback of giving some appreciation as well as some room for improvement. That whilst you could do all these things very nicely, can't you understand this is also equally important? Can't you take care of this? It'll be very nice. It'll be just one step forward, one step ahead of whatever you're doing. And in the worst case scenario, at least we can be stern, but not keep a criticizing mentality. Criticizing mentality is about what we have just read today. You make certain act in such a manner that you force that person to commit an act so that you can humiliate him. So, when you have to warn, when you have to educate someone, you can definitely be stern, even to an extent to be upset, but not criticize, because criticism is about one step further, where you kind of getting into a punitive punishing and taking rules on your hand and in a conclusive manner, which is not our service, at least in a general sense. Does it make sense, Mataji?
Yes, Prabhuji, but just in case if there is somebody who is a devotee but who has the habit of cheat, so if I have to warn you against that person, what do I say?
That's okay, you can communicate. I mean, if you have to warn, yeah, that's a very nice point. So basically, we can, in an intent of making sure that furthermore devotees are not going to get affected, you can share your experience without adding mirchi masala. Generally, what happens is that the episode is X, we add 4X. Intent, facial expression, hair, dress, interpretation, inference, so many things. So unless it is really an explicit one like pedophiles and rapists and some sort of an extreme things, I guess we can be little naive enough to say that be careful. Make sure that when you are dealing with such and such person, you are very well informed of his whatever challenges. And this was my experience. And probably in your case, you be careful. You can always say that. See, basically, there's just a thin difference. The thin difference is, one is to complain, second is to you know, warn, third is to criticize. And these three have a three different flavor. The moment criticism comes, we add one special layer called I try to pull him down, or I'll try to humiliate, or I'll try to see to that he is getting a, you know, a sufficient punishment or sufficient humiliation. But in terms of warrant, at least your interest is not about other persons being shown down. Your interest is to rescue your friend. So it's just a thin difference, but at least, you know, we should be careful so that our consciousness is not hampered. Otherwise, to even complain, even to warn your friend, you may need to take so much of extra endeavor in thinking about the person's bad activities, the whole day will go in criticizing that person internally. Does it make sense, Madhuri?
Yes, Prabhu. Thank you so much. Thank you very much. Dandavat Pranam.
Any other questions or comments? Okay, thank you so much for giving this opportunity to be part of the Sangha. This is a very interesting topic. I sincerely encourage that the next aspect of this chapter is, I mean, very interesting, as I was explaining how the difference between Ishwara Puri and Ramachandra Puri was about the service attitude. So please, you know, hear that part also. Very nice. Ishwara Puri eventually got Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as his disciple. So if we also serve the spiritual authorities unconditionally, then for sure we will be blessed with the Supreme Lord's blessings. Wish you all the best. Param Vijayate Sri Krishna Sankirtanam Ki Jai, Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai.
Thank you very much, Prabhuji, for enlightening us. And we are very grateful to you. We look forward to your association, Prabhuji. Thank you very much. Banshakal Patal Vyascha Kripasindu Bhivacha Patidhanam Pavane Vyo Vishnupiyanam Ananta Kutti Vyasani
Jai, Shri Prabhupada Ki Jai. Thank you so much, Prabhuji. It's a very wonderful.
Thank you, Prabhu.
Thank you, Prabhuji. Koti Koti Dandavat Pranam. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Thank you so much, Prabhuji.
Thank you, Madhina.